News conference there in Santa Fe just moments ago. This is the first time authorities are speaking at length about what happened on that movie set. They talked moments ago about the two other people who handled the weapon. In addition to actor Alec Baldwin, Hannah Gutierrez-Reed, the armorer who prepares any sort of guns on set for this type of thing, and the assistant director, David Halls. They said they have recovered three firearms from the scene, and this was telling. They said they've recovered 500 rounds of ammunition on the scene, that ammunition would be made up of blanks and live rounds, according to the sheriff there. They said the projectile has been recovered from the shoulder of Mr. Souza. Of course, that is the person who survived this. They believe that it's the same live round that killed the Helena Hutchins, the director of photography on that set. The DA saying, I do not make rash decisions. When asked if Alec Baldwin could face potential charges, she said all options are on the table. No one has been ruled out to face any potential charges. I want to bring in Kaylee Hartung, who's been on the scene from the very beginning with us here. Kaylee, one thing that was a bit confusing was that at one point the sheriff said there was other ammunition in the gun, and then just moments ago he was asked, was there any other live rounds in that gun, and he said, we don't believe so. So perhaps he'll clarify that. But again, he said there certainly was one live round in the gun, and that was fired by actor Alec Baldwin.
Yeah, David, this is the first time we have heard the sheriff directly say this was a bullet that was fired out of that gun that pierced through Helena Hutchins and then was lodged in Joel Souza's shoulder. This bullet recovered from his shoulder. Now, it's clear that the focus of this investigation is all about the ballistics. And the bigger question, of course, how did that live round get into that gun? The sheriff saying they have identified the two people who handled that gun before it was given to Alec Baldwin. That is the armorer, Hannah Gutierrez-Reed, and the film's assistant director, Dave Halls. The sheriff confirming they have both been interviewed. But here for the first time, we are hearing, David, it was in fact a bullet, a live round bullet, that caused this tragedy. Up until now, what we've heard so much discussion of is a projectile, the discussion of ammunition. But we've learned that that ammunition could be on a film set in the form of a blank, in the form of a dummy, and now we know a bullet. Though bullets largely banned on film sets, people in the movie industry telling me it is unfathomable how a bullet could end up on this film set. But now we know that is what happened, and they will continue this investigation, continue these ballistics testing to figure out how this happened, what types of bullets they were, and how many there were among the 600 items they collected, saying 500 rounds of ammunition were recovered. It's clear this is going to be a long investigation. It is clear this could take weeks, if not months, before we see any potential charges here, David.
All right, Kaylee Hartung there on the scene. Kaylee, and just to underscore what you heard from Kaylee there moments ago, the question from reporters for authorities there was, how could they not notice a live round was in that firearm, since every firearm on a movie set is inspected before it's handed to the actor? And then Kaylee's point there is, how was there a live round at all on that movie set? They did confirm today that it was, in fact, a live round fired from that gun. And in addition to that, they said 500 rounds of ammunition recovered from the movie set. The sheriff said he suspects that is made up of blanks and of live rounds. I want to bring in our chief legal analyst, Dan Abrams, because, Dan, we heard the DA there also say, we can't say it was negligence by whom. Making clear that she believes there's negligence. She's just not ready to say by whom at this point. And again, she said of Alec Baldwin, all options on the table. No one has been ruled out.
Yeah, and you heard the sheriff there say that there was, quote, some complacency on the set. I think that may be an understatement. Both the sheriff and the district attorney being very careful about the words they're using here, being very careful to ensure that nothing is taken out of context. There was a question, is Alec Baldwin a person of interest, which is not really the language you'd use in this kind of investigation. Very carefully, the sheriff changing the topic there. The most interesting things, and I think important, that I heard from this press conference, number one, everyone's being cooperative. That's very important here. There's no one who's, quote, lawyered up and is refusing to help. That makes a big difference in an investigation like this. Number two is when he said that there were possible other live rounds found on the set. That is a real potential problem for the producers and the other people in charge of this set. Because if there were other live rounds found on the set, The question is going to be why. As you heard Kaylee talking about there, there is no reason that there should be live rounds on a set. And if there was this single bullet in the gun, someone might say, well, you know, there was this one mistake. It's if there were multiple live rounds, now you're talking about a real potential legal issue. And you heard the district attorney say that what happens on other sets, meaning other problems that could be related to people here, will be relevant, she said, in her legal analysis. So I think we do have a ways to go here in this investigation, but it certainly seems the beginning of a criminal investigation has started.
And Dan, just to underscore that point you made there, perhaps the argument could have been made at some point along the way that that was simply a mistake, that there was one live round left in the gun. Still, that would have been perhaps some sort of negligence. But when you hear the sheriff say there has been several rounds, hundreds of rounds of ammunition recovered from that movie set, and that some of it could be live rounds, therein lies what could be a very significant problem moving forward.
Right. Huge difference between live rounds and blanks or dummies when it comes to a movie set. There is simply no reason live rounds should be on a set. And the question is, how did it get there? That in and of itself is negligence. The question's going to be, who was responsible? We know about the two people who touched the gun, who were responsible, in essence, for this happening, but we don't know exactly what they did and didn't do. What were their responsibilities? Why did they do what they did? These are all the questions that are going to have to be asked and answered, and those questions will determine whether there will be any criminal charges here.
Dan Abrams with us this afternoon as we hear from authorities there in Santa Fe moments ago, saying their investigation continues, but it was the first time we heard from them about what they have recovered from the scene, who has been interviewed so far, and as Dan pointed out, saying so far everyone has been cooperative on set. Our coverage will continue at ABC News Live and abcnews.com, and of course, I'll be back with a full report later this afternoon on World News Tonight. I'm David Muir in New York. Good day.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.